Hey everybody, Zealous1826 here. Welcome back for more Final Fantasy VI. In the last part, we took place in an epic war. We won! And now we have to go find Terra because she flew off somewhere. So... Edgar gave us a hint to go to Figaro Castle. And we can use it to go west. But since we're here in Nar, there's a couple things we can do. I don't think we can go in here yet. Oh, yeah, we can. There's one treasure chest near the back that won't open no matter what you do. I wonder if anybody can get it open. It's locked. Why can't frickin' Locke open it, man? Thief bangle. Reflect ring. I got something else in that first chest. I don't remember what it said. 5,000 gil. Earring. And a thief's knife. Okay, most of the stuff is for Locke, so... Give him the thief's knife. That's a nice boost to speed attack and face up and magic face up too. That thief's bangle we got is an accessory for him. Raises success rate of steel, which is exactly what he needs because he's having a rough time stealing stuff. That's what I got, another hyperus, I think, wasn't it? Peace ring, prevents confusion and berserk. Yep, I was right last time. Alright, reflect ring, cast reflect. Let's give him the shoes for now. Alright. I think these pots have something? No, I didn't think so. I thought that clock had something too, but I can't access it because that guy's in the way. Now that we actually have access to Narsh, we can start going to the shops and seeing what they have for sale. So let's go to the shops and see what they have. The weapon shop, I think. No, it's the armor shop. Let's go in there. What do you got, dude? Mithril shields. Holy crap, I can just now buy them. Let's buy three. I have a lot of money. Holy crap. Let's give everybody mithril shields. Except him. He doesn't have a shield. I think there's something in this block. Let's see. No, didn't think so. Where's the weapon shop? Let's find the weapon shop. There it is. Alright. What do you got, old man? Great sword, mithril claw, katetsu, mithril spear, air knife, chain flail. Let's give that to her. Same damage dealt from the back row. I don't know how much better that is for Locke, but I'm gonna look and see. It's plus attack, but it's minus everything else. No, I'll hang on to it for now. I'll definitely give her that and throw her in the back row. Since when she attacks, she can... It won't affect her damage if she's in the back row. I think I'm gonna... Let's see. I don't know if I need to do this, but I'm gonna do it anyway. Alright. Now let's head to Figaro, since we know how to get there. Alright. Go this way, save it. Since we just got out of that long 30-minute war, holy crap! Let's head to Figaro! And run into enemies! Leafy buns! Kill them with ice. Oh, it heals them. That's nice. Get him, Edgar. Overkill is go. Ta-da. Sweet. Continuing on to Figaro. I'll probably run into something here because I didn't fight anything in the desert before. Okay. Whatever. Let's go. Sir Edgar, welcome back. I think you could unlock a scene with Edgar and Sabin here, if I'm not mistaken, now that you have them both in your group. Yes, you can! Woohoo! I'm gonna look around the castle for a bit. Bye, Sabin. No, not here. Oh, I know where it is. Now, if you have Edgar in the front of your group, and you talk to those merchants again, I think they cut the price in half or something? I can't charge the king money. You have a family to take care of. I think I should pay. And for this, we get two new weapons. Or two new machines for Edgar. We get the Sunbeam, causes darkness and damage. It was called Flash in the original game, and of course there's a drill. Ignores defense, damages enemies via the machine command. That's a very nice machine. It deals damage no matter what, because of the, it ignores defense. Where do I activate this cutscene? I don't remember. Oh, I know where it is. I think. It's a very touching little scene, so... I think it's in this way. Yep, it's this way. Will you take a rest? Go ahead and take a rest. There's Sabin looking around. He's back in the throne room. Nothing has changed. Even the castle. Yeah, I have Edgar's chair. But then again, it's all so different ever since Father died. Everything changed on that day. This evening, things took a turn for the worse. No, it can't be. You lie. Matron, the king, he's... Sabin! No! Get back here. My father is... Big brother. So they went and told you. Father is... Sir Edgar, what are you doing out here? Just now, your father. He's declared that Figaro be to be divided between you two. You fools. Everybody, they all say the Empire poisoned Father. All you care about is who's going to ascend to the throne. Well, I don't want any part of that. My mother died giving birth to me. No one cried then either. That isn't... You are just like the rest of them. Sabin. Empire of killers, more like. I won't let them go on like this. Matron, we need some time alone. I'm leaving this country. I'm going to leave the land of my birth behind and live free. Big brother, didn't you say that you weren't interested in the throne either? Freedom. But if we both leave, who will rule this country and its people? Father wouldn't want that. Sabin, let's decide using this coin Father gave us. If it turns up tails, you win. If it's heads, I win. Pick a head. We both have a fair chance of winning, okay? Okay. Ha! God, this music gets me every time I hear it. And then you chose freedom. Eh. Edgar, look at... What are you hiding back there? 10 years. You've grown up to be quite a bear. And you've become quite the king yourself. Sabin, I often wonder, will Father be proud of the king I've become? I have no doubt. Father's cheering you on from the spirit world. 10 years. Such a long time. Very long. Oh, here we are. Two brothers lost and confused, even as adults. A toast to Father. to Mother, and to Figaro. Yay! And Sabin's back in our group. That cutscene, I swear, it always gets me. But anyway, let's progress with the story, shall we? Go down these steps, talk to this guy. There have been many orders this month. If it's your wish, I can take the castle beyond the northern mountain range. Go to Corlingen. Heave-ho! And we get to travel into the castle that goes under the sand and under the mountains. Which is kind of cool, I like that. It's definitely a unique way to travel, for sure. I think the town, if I'm not mistaken, is directly north of us, so we're gonna head up north as soon as I get out of here. We're at Corlingen Village, watch your step. Alright, let's get out of here. Shall we? Go north. Yep, there's a village. Oh, hello. Dragon Foss. Oh boy. Kill this thing with a phoenix down, it's a lot easier. Yeah, that thing can be quite devious if you don't know how to deal with it. But if you have enough phoenix downs, hell, use them. Overwrite this data, yes, please. Corlingen Village! Hey, you. An amazingly bright light came here. Everybody was afraid that it would fry them, but I thought it was beautiful. Is that ball of light really a monster? It stopped right in front of me when it came here, but I could see it had gentle eyes. The monster of light stopped here in the village not too long ago. I was scared. It flew south towards Judor. Okay, so it flew south. Oh, my house. The monster of light came and burned it to the ground as it flew past. My younger brother is a bit disturbed. He lives up north by himself and says that he dreams of making a coliseum. Hey, is that you, Locke? Have you been to Rachael's house yet? Rachael's house? Who'd be Rachael? I already talked to this guy. Oops. Damn it! No, I don't want to talk to him again. Damn it! Hey. A girl named Rachael used to live in that house over there, but now it's abandoned. Let's go in and check it out, shall we? I failed to protect her. Oh god, this cutscene! Locke, what will we be treasure hunting for today? You'll see soon. They say that an amazing treasure is hidden in this mountain. We're going to find it. Locke, look out! Rachael! Rachael, you're awake. More dots! I can't remember anything. Oh no. Go away. It's your fault our daughter has lost her memory. Wait, Rachael and I were going to... Go on. I don't know who you are, but ever since you've arrived, my family has been very upset. You better leave Rachael alone. She has to start her life over again. Locke, your being here is just making it harder for her. And thus, Locke leaves town. A year passed. When I returned, I found out that Rachael was injured during an attack by the Empire while I was away. Her memory returned just before she died. The last thing she uttered before she died was my name. I never should have left her side. I failed to protect her. Oh my god, that scene! Received elixir from the chest, the clock. Hey, is that you, Locke? Yeah, I already talked to you. Her memory returned just before she died. She made one last request of us. Please tell Locke that when he comes back, that I loved him with all my heart. Oh! It is my dream to one day go to the opera theater to the south of Jador. If I ever did, I'd go in a fine dress and with a handsome escort. Duh. It'd be a wise view of wooded the house on the far eastern edge of the village. The old kook living there is messing with strange concoctions all the time. I heard that he has ghosts under his house. That makes me even more curious. Let's go check it out. Oh. Check that stuff. Funky music. Oh, is that you, Locke? It's been a long time. A long time. Eh? What's that? Don't you worry. I'm taking good care of your little treasure for you. Rachael? I used my concoction to steal their soul from time. That's what Locke wanted. I had used my concoctions, I did. Rachael. Those medicines of yours really work? Of course, of course. This dear girl of yours will sleep like this forever, safe from the death that would have claimed her otherwise. But what if we find a way to free her soul? You think you can call her soul back somehow, hmm? Well, I'm sure if you can find someone to revive her, you'll pull it off. I failed to protect her. And now we know why Locke is so protective over the women. God, that scene with Rachael. Gets me. Just go in the back here, you get a green beret. Anyway, I think that's enough tear-jerking scenes for one part. I'm okay. But anyway, I'm going to save it and I'm going to call this an episode, guys. So next time on Final Fantasy VI, we're going to continue our search for Dara. I'll see you guys then.